Peace and power. Welcome back to the Next Nuclear Radio Show. I am your host, Zireus Razus Nuclear, leader of the United Nations of Next Nuclear. Again, welcome back to the Next Nuclear Radio Show. I am your host, Zireus Razus Nuclear, leader of the United Nations of Next Nuclear. And today's topic is Limitless Thinkers of the Now and the Next. Again, Limitless Thinkers of the Now and the Next. So here we have it. We are receiving extended pictures of ourselves, extended ideas of us on this continuous path. And you know, we see these images as a collective of these bright bronze or these diamond bright bronze beings. We see the images coming in. We see what's on the horizon or beyond the horizon that is now fastly approaching us. This very, very shift that is commonly being spoke of on Facebook, on YouTube, you know, all of these people who are in tune with this energy that know what's going on. And we are becoming limitless thinkers, or we are these limitless thinkers, as these diamonded bronze golden beings. We are able to pull in this reception and think, you know, we're tuning in, minding out instead of minding in this third dimension, and we're minding out of into the fourth dimension, receiving this full transmission, receiving this information that will extend us and ultimately make us the most intelligent ones. We will become that blue light spectrum that I mentioned being the fastest moving light spectrum in our horizon, because our skies are blue, the color sky blue. So that's why I mention it all the time. So we will become those blue light spectrums, being the fastest moving and the fastest thinking, moving in 111111111, instead of moving in 1212 like the humans. We're moving 11111. That's forward motion. That's forward. Whereas the humans 1212, you know, it's crazy that we all have to see it like that. But now we are all just going to actually evolve on this path, because we see it this way, because we're the only ones able to pull in full reception, because we all understand that we know that in these times where no one's really understanding what we're saying or what we're pulling in, we just truly have to come together as a collective, and we have to be able to see, and we have to be able to ultimately pull in more of this extended reception to move us down this path and away from these third dimensional thinkers and away from these two dimensional thinkers, because they're not pulling in anything. They are not pulling in anything. And you know, we're just going to constantly be, what you say, thinking above them, or you know, y'all thinking ahead, pretty much. You know, they're going to have any, you know, these negative ways to you know, try to down us and being these limitless thinkers, because we are limitless thinkers, and we are pulling in extended ideas, extended pictures that, you know, ultimately is our future in community, our future in unity. And for the ones who can't see that, that's because they're not pulling in on no higher level. You know, they're only seeing everything for the physical and out of the mental. You know, they can't see on this level, because it's just a fact that they're black, mentally black. You know, it's not because their skin is black, but because their minds are black. So when your mind is black, you can't pull anything in, and you can't be a limitless thinker. You know, when your mind is black, not because your skin is black. I'll say it again for the ones who can't hear, and also for the ones who don't understand this message. Your skin is not black. Your mind is black as a black person. So here we are as these diamond bright bronze people, because our skin is bronze and brass to a golden hue. So this is what you call a limitless idea that we can all come to an agreement on as these limitless thinkers, or these bright diamond bronze people. We ultimately can see, you know, what this purpose is, what, you know, ultimately what we have to do to extend ourselves forward, which is by way of community, which is by way of channeling in this frequency to be able to ultimately see our bloodlines in the future. To ultimately be able to see our bloodlines in the future, we're channeling in this new transmission, this next nuclear transmission that can't be broken, that can't be stopped, that can't be faltered by way of any of these two-dimensional and third-dimensional people that want to try to come at us, or who try to stop us on this path, who see that, you know, hey, you know, we, because I'm telling you, you're going to have these people, which they're called detractors, who will say that, you know, you're not pulling anything. You're just a regular person. You know, don't believe that. Don't even acknowledge that, because you have to understand we are the brightest ones, or the fastest moving light spectrums, or the fastest moving energy here on this planet. We are that blue light spectrum I told you about that we can observe in the sky, which is actually sky blue. The sky is actually blue. We are the ones ultimately moving and thinking ahead of these humans. We are ahead of these humans thinking. We're so much mentally advanced. You know, they got their technology that they have nowadays, but we're pulling in stuff that's rivaling it. When you can pull in a full image, when you can actually pull in, you know, full pictures, ideas from these other dimensions, these other realms that our souls drift to when we're in sleep. Because that's the one thing, you know, me and my, you know, community members, you know, we actually spoke about this, and we all, you know, happen to be able to, we come to a conclusion, or it makes sense that our souls drift when we are sleeping, you know, which you could, they consider that conscious, or our souls drift, you know, us being able to, what you say, astral project, you know, we can, you know, send residual images or after images by way of our body, or by way of sleep, you know, we can cast after images, and you know, I would say not even being aware of us doing that, but you know, to be able to do it, what you say, consciously or aware, is a limitless thought, limitless ideas, limitless pictures that we can channel in on the fourth dimension, on the you know, on these other extended planes of living, not existence. You know, just sorry about the noise in the background. I'm trying to just, you know, talk over it. But the point being is, yes, we are these limitless thinkers, and we are now and in the next, because we can see ourselves in the next. But, you know, a lot of these black people, black thinking people, can't see themselves in the future. That's why it said this is over their heads. This is over their heads, and they'll rather have God or Jesus, you know, take the wheel. They'd rather have Jesus and God take the wheel, because they're not too intelligent or bright enough to be able to see in these further extended, what you say, planes of living. These are extended planes of living where we live, not exist. We live in these realms. We have supremacy, because here in third dimension, this is not a living. This is existing, because we are not supreme. We are not supreme, because we have to answer to these humans, and these humans, which you say, have some kind of authority over us, which is, you know, really null and void at this point. Null and void at this point, because we've already reclaimed our minds. Once we already reclaim the mind, being able to think is through the mind. They had us stooped for all these years by confusing us by way of our minds. All of this stuff that they had us believing in, and now the word, we're coming out of that we are the next nuclear idea and thought process. We are able to pass all of these, what you say, mediocre, and, you know, pass down the theories and thought and stories that they pass down as truths, knowing that they're lies now, because we're thinking ahead of the curve. We're thinking ahead of the curve, and we're living ahead of the curve. Not this ahead of the curve. We're actually living ahead of the curve. We're living ahead of the curve and thinking ahead of the curve, thinking of ahead of the curve. No more existing and believing below the curve, if that makes sense, because that's ultimately what they had as duped through with all of these scare tactics, everything with politics and all of this stuff is so irrelevant. That's why I've yet to watch anything on the politics of Donald Trump and, you know, Biden, all of that. But I continue to receive these, you know, flyers and stuff at my door, which it's pissing me off, because I don't care about any of that shit. Because we're limitless thinkers, and we don't care about this irrelevant shit, because it don't matter. Because when you vote for these motherfuckers, you're gonna still be a black person no matter fucking what. You're gonna still be a nigger in their eyes. You'll still be a nigger, a second class to everybody in this damn society. So it don't matter. So we limitless thinkers, and we're above that. We're limitless bright diamond bronze people. No, limitless bright bronze thinkers. And we're moving ahead of the curve. That's why I said it's now and next. Now and next, we're going to be at the head of the curve. Now and next, we're going to be mentally extended, mentally supreme, physically supreme, physically limitless, mentally limitless. All of that, that will be us. We will rule supreme in that. That is that is basically our, what they say in the Bible, our birthright. No, that's going to be our birthright once we are, what you say, pro-manifested back into the fourth dimension because our bloodline would have made it by then. It'll be extended by then. You know, for the ones of us who do make it down this path, because the continuous, you know, not everybody's built for the continuous, but there's going to be a lot of us that do make it and a lot of us that don't make it. But, you know, let's just keep moving forward because we're limitless. These limitless thinkers don't, you know, train their thoughts on what you say, remedial ideas or just ideas that don't stimulate growth. You know, it has to be forward thinking. It has to be forward motion. We're not focused on anything that's revolving doors. We're not focused, like I said, I'm saying it again. We're not focused on things that's like revolving doors. It's a never ending cycle. It has to be straightforward. It has to be straightforward and to the point. And it has to be meaningful and useful for a collective and not for just one person. So that's how you know it's just, you know, for us as these limitless thinkers, everything has to be logic and rational. Everything has to be logic and rational. So, you know, we see the bigger picture as these limitless thinkers. There is no, you know, seeing anything one-sided. We're seeing it in all dimensional forms and possibilities as these limitless thinkers. We see it in all dimensional and, you know, physical possibilities, you know, dimensional physical possibilities and dimensional mental possibilities too, as well. So, you know, we're seeing this now and next. We're seeing our extended self, you know, pulling in our meaningful and our purpose. I mean, our knowing our purpose and knowing that we're needed, knowing that we're necessary into the future. Because if you weren't necessary and needed into the future, then you won't be able to see yourself there. Point blank, period. You're going to say, hey, you know, people always believe that they're going to just die here and then that's it. Or they're going to heaven. So, you know, a lot of them, they have that what you call that mediocre or what you say hand-me-down theory of by the humans of how life works, which is truly a lie. They don't really believe that. They believe that, you know, they reincarnate because, yeah, they're of the created. They know they're created here, but we don't reincarnate unless we didn't learn our lesson. And sadly, that was how it was for a lot of us. We come back here now because we have not learned our lesson. And no, now because we've somehow gotten some of our memory back, some of who we think we really were and who we know we really were back then, we've now become these limitless extended thinkers because we have been able to connect the dots and learn from the past mistakes of our ancestors. And we know better now because when you know better, you do better. And that's the thing. We're just logical and rational because a lot of the so-called past leaders and, you know, past what you say representations of us as a collective being under the term black, you know, they weren't as logical and, you know, logical, and they didn't have the rational, you know, mindset to be able to, you know, plot a course into an extended state, because, you know, we're still talking about bigging up, you know, Malcolm X and, you know, Martin Luther King. You know, we shouldn't big these people up because they wanted us to beg. Well, no, I wouldn't say Malcolm X, but I would say Martin Luther King. We shouldn't big him up because he was begging for us to ask for equality. We don't want equality from these filthy, dirty ass motherfuckers. We don't want them. We don't want no equality because you see what has done for us. They still continue to beat us and kill us. And then, you know, they integrated their schools now. So it makes it more easier for them to get away with a lot of shit like that. So, you know, we were better off separated from them. Yes. Segregation was an actual nice thing because we were literally pulling in a lot more things. We were doing for self a lot more than asking, because we trying to come together and unify with people, and we're asking for handouts and all this from the people that still don't like your guts because they can't be you. They still want to ask for the handouts and love these people and lay down with these people. Even though, you know, it is sad because when you're a limitless thinker, you would see like that. Hey, let's get away from these people. Hey, there's some fucked up ass people. They're sick in the head. But people can't come that quickly because they want to be a everybody ass person. They want to be a everybody ass person. They want to be in their face, smile on their face, making them laugh, just boot licking and being a straight up ass coon, because they really want to be in front of these so-called humans and get their approval. Well, fuck their approval, because fuck them. They ain't shit no way. Fuck them. And fuck you, so-called black people, because y'all sit up there and make us all look bad under that damn term, because I don't even go by that term, but still, I still have to go into the public eye and still have to go under that term black. It's pathetic. It's a damn shame. Y'all still don't get the damn cycle in the game they plan on y'all dumbasses. So here we go again as these limitless thinkers. You know, this is going to be raw and uncut because we have to hear this. We have to hear this. There's no more because it, just like we had that retrograde that hit us maybe last week or so, we were affected by retrograde a couple weeks ago. It's only going to get worse. And that means our transmission and frequency is only going to be picked up. It's only going to be strengthened. Those, like I said, those on waves, those what you say on radio waves, those frequencies from on high are going to become short waves. They're going to be coming so fast that it's like boop, boop, boop. Like I said, 1-1-1-1-1-1-1, not 1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2. No, it's 1-1-1-1-1-1-1. It's one frequency consistent and continuous that's coming down here, hitting us. And you think it's gonna be, and you thought it was bad last week, just wait. Because, and we only just entered October. Well, October's almost over, so, you know, but just in that particular bracket of this month, you know, you really felt that energy pick up. It shifted, it elevated. So, like I said, here we are moving forward. You know, our thoughts are only gonna move just like that. You know, our limited ideas, you know, because we're not gonna be limited in thought. In the mental, we can't be limited in the mental, because you know the crazy part is most of these computers are made just like us. You know, they cannot limit our thinking. Our thinking is extended, because when you really try to press the envelope, it's going to happen. Your what you say, your carbonated brain or carbonated mind will become a diamondated mind and brain, and it will ultimately begin to reflect like that prism and pull in those many different facets of information, the different channels. Channel 4, 8 and 12 in between, and you know, inner and outer those channels, we'll be able to pick up bits and bits of frequencies and at an increased level as limitless thinkers, I would say limitless channelers. You know, we could say that, you know, if y'all want to go there, limitless channelers, being able to channel in things that can move us forward and move the planet forward, because for the ones who are really evolved, we're going to receive these ideas and transmissions. We're going to become super sensitized empaths. When I say it again, super sensitized empaths or channelers, super sensitized empaths and channelers. We're going to be pulling up. We're going to be so sensitive. We're going to be just be able to pull in our mental. Just our minds are going to be so sensitive. They're going to be able to just pull in frequency at will, just like how I started to begin by doing these podcasts, pulling in super sensitized mental ideas, capabilities. Our minds will become super sensitive, or super sensors drawing in energy, drawing in that power, drawing in ideas. Excuse me. So again, like super sensors or super scanners, scanners. Super transmitters and scanners, being able to sweep, like I said, MAS, you know, mental air sweeping, you know, being able to mentally scan the airways above you, scan the atmosphere around you, and you know, hone in on each, you know, what's what energy, whether it's a helicopter, a plane, or just the, you know, simple stuff like that. You know, they have their own, you know, they know we have that ability. So they created their what you so-called helicopters and planes, you know, based off our ability, because they know what we got. You know, we are known as these sensitized beings, you know, being able to sense, you know, energy shifts, knowing when it might rain or when it will rain. That's just not intuition. That's an ability to tap into the atmosphere and know when heavy pressurized systems are going to come in, or you feel it. You feel those heavy pressurized systems coming in because you feel it, because you have that ability. Your mind is sweeping the air for energy shifts at all times. That's what we're going to have. That's what we have now. We have those early stages of that right now as these limitless thinkers of the now and the next. And it's only going to get more amplified because we're a collective. When we're a collective sharing ideas, you know, doing what we have to do as far as, you know, what our purpose is, extending our brightness, we're receiving and pulling in as limitless thinkers, and we're extending ourselves and other people around us by way of our brightness, and ultimately it turns into intelligence, and it turns into light once other people pick it up. because everything, it's not going to have the same effect when we receive it, when we tell it to somebody else that's thinking on a lower level. Trust me, you've all experienced that before, where you think you've had a good idea, or you know it was a fire, like bona fide fire idea, or, you know, high level thought and high level idea of transmission, and you present it to a regular so-called thinking person, and they were like, oh, okay, yeah, that's pretty cool, all dual and nonchalant, trying to play it off, like, and but to you, you feel like, damn, like, that person not paying attention. Yeah, that's really what it is. Yeah, you know, that's because, you know, it's because you're channeling and thinking on a higher level. You're pulling in because you're what you say, that hypersensitized thinker, you know, because the muscles, think about it, the muscles in your mind have to be moving at an incredible, like the reflex muscles to be able, like I told you, the carnu amonis, that muscle in the hippocampus of the brain, that's basically a muscle that twitches, and basically it reflects because of signal and vibration. So it's twitching by producing idea and thoughts by my way of me speaking. I'm at the same time thinking and speaking it, I'm also receiving it one way, like I said, like a walkie-talkie, being able to receive transmission and idea just like that. That is all by way of this limitless thinking, by way of this extended mental picture, by way of this energy coming down, and by way of just the evolution that I am going through and we're all going through. I'm not just the only one doing this. There are a lot of people that I know that I've come in connection with that are doing this. But whew, when you're doing it on, you know, levels to where it's, you know, I wouldn't say it's live, but, you know, it's live when I record this, but at the same time, it's all just these are all upgrades, evolution that we're stepping into. So we are all on this, you know, mental wave or mental pattern that we're all tapping in. And some of us are even going higher. Some of us have stumbled and, you know, just miraculously been able to, you know, pull in more and more extended pictures and ideas. You know, these are ones to where, you know, this is like, it's, you know, there's many frequencies to tap into. You know, the frequency of the 2D is that, you know, everyone is the same and we should all come together and unify. But third dimension is, no, we need to come together as bright collective people of the same race and same people. You know, it's based off of like identifying as who you are and who you represent, because, you know, no matter where you're going, you know, even if you do a sin, you know, you still have to represent it, because you mean you still have to be remembered. You're going to be remembered by way of your energy signal. So by way of your, you know, energy, by your energy resonation, how bright did you burn yourself in the third dimension, pretty much, your energy resonance or your energy memory, like how bright did you explode? Because technically speaking, we are stars. We are the composition of a star. If we have the same energy and vibration of the sun is a star, so we are stars. So how bright did you burn yourself here on Earth? How big of a mark did you make here on this planet is ultimately what we're looking at and what we need to understand as these limitless thinkers. We are limited. I mean we're not limited by, you know, anything of the third dimension, and we're not limited by anything lower than that, because everything that's, you know, lower than the fourth dimension is just primitive. We are above and beyond. Not to infinity, but to eternity and beyond. To eternity and beyond, we have stepped up our mental reception game. You know, we've been able to step up our, you know, physical, you know, what you say, physical motion. You know, being able to, because as we're extending and pulling in more energy, because light code or bright code is energy, our bodies ultimately take in or take on a different shape. It takes on a more extended image of who we are now. We become more extended in the physical, which I mean is immortality, which means we live longer, which means if we're living longer, we're pulling in higher and way more extended transmission and more ideas as limitless thinkers, as these limitless thinkers, we see that our higher purpose is to be of the blue, the fastest thinking, the fastest moving. And then after that is the ultraviolet, which we can't see. Now, once we become to that point, that means we will be able to basically go in and out, upper and outer. Like I said, we can go to the fourth dimension and to the third dimension. We can go back and forth if we choose to, but there's no point to go to the third dimension because it's already going to be pretty much done with, done over. We're going to be in the fourth dimension in these extended states and pulling in extended thought and ideas that will mold us and give us more dimension. As these diamonds, we are diamonds because each dimension that we go up is like a different face of a diamond. If you think about it, each dimension of a diamond is a different face, or each realm or dimension we go up to as these diamond beings will ultimately add or etch a different face, or you know, etch a different spectrum of what you say brightness of us. Each spectrum of brightness equals each different phase of that diamond or each different phase that we will that will be added to us or accrued to us as we evolve, you know. And here we have it now, going into 2021, because we're just like what, 2 months away at this point. Now we're heading into 2021, and that represents the what? The one represents the linear path. But I told you, one is the linear path. So a lot of people who didn't make it in 2020 was because they got caught up. And for the ones that will ultimately die later on, leading into 2021, they will be caught up in what you call that that equal realm, that equilibrium realm, which represents what you would say the two. Two represents the spirit realm. And 2020 ultimately represents, because it's still of the zero. I mean, it's four, of course, which represents what they say, 2020 vision, clear vision. At the same time, we've seen a lot of things that would represent clear vision, but we've seen a lot of confusion that's going on. A lot of confusion. Let alone 2021 represents the one. So it's 40, it's 41, not 40. And zero represents that circular path. A lot of things that's being done down here in 2020 is all just repeat of the past. They've been repeating and doing a lot of things in front of our faces that they've done in the past. You know, that represents the zero, that revolution. We don't represent revolving doors. We're linear. So in 2021, we're supposed to be skyrocketing out of this place as far as on the mental plane and on the physical plane, because it's 2021. We're supposed to be doing, because we know better of 2020, we're supposed to be knowing better and doing better in 2021. That is the next step. If we are, because we've seen 2020 as an example. Yeah, we weren't. No, I don't think a lot of people were prepared. I don't think a lot of people were prepared for 2020 to come in just the way it did, and the way it's happening now. Yeah, nobody was ready for it. You know, a lot of people weren't prepared. I mean, some were. Okay, I can't sit up there and say that all of us weren't, but there were some that were prepared. But that's because they were what you would call limitless thinkers. They were extended thinkers, forward thinkers. They saw that, you know, you can't trust this society, because you can't trust this ever-changing society. You can't put your trust in, or your so-called faith in this ever-changing society, knowing what's going on, knowing that, you know, at any time they could try to come and take your, what you call your civil liberties or your rights, you know, try to come in and harm you in so many ways. So we don't associate ourselves with these people. That's why we say to ourselves. That's why it's best that we have a community, so we don't have to rely on anybody else outside of the community. That makes a lot of sense. Why should I have to go outside the community to, you know, get certain supplies when I know my brother Raheem or, you know, some other cat up the street might have these products, you know, for maybe the same price, maybe a little cheaper, maybe a little more, but hey, he's just like me, he looks like me, so I would do that. I'm not gonna go to the enemy side, just to get certain product. That's just, you know, it doesn't make sense. That's why so-called black people have a backward thinking mentality, because they can't even see that. They rather go to Wing and Ming, Chinese food place, and you know, basically, you know, not even try to go or appreciate a so-called black-owned or so-called bronze-owned, you know, food chain. You know, whether it's jerk chicken or that good, you know, come on now, please, you know what I'm talking about. You know, you as these bright brown people, you guys know what I'm talking about. Where is the love for our so-called, you know, bronze establishments out here? You know, I'm starting to see more and more come up, but, you know, that will be us as the community or the United Nations of Next Nuclear. You know, we're going to be extending ourselves by way of, you know, these, those particular avenues moving forward. And that's guaranteed. That is guaranteed. We're going to be extending ourselves on all avenues, because we have to be the masters of people, places, and possessions, okay? We have to be the masters of people, places, and possessions. That means on all levels, economic, you know, as far as like on the mental and the physical, and, you know, the economic level. You know, we're not going on politics, but we have to be a governmental body. So, yes, we have to do politics, yes, because we have to be a government, a governmental body. We have to control these people, you know, these humans with these hybrids, and we're going to have to be controlling the so-called degenerate black people that are still left, that didn't decide to cross over. You know, we're going to be the ones having to, you know, rule over them as these, as those Inki and Leolites, you know, being able to be the masters of both, the earth and the land, I mean, earth and the skies, or, you know, the gods of the earth and the gods of the sky, pretty much. We're going to be able to have to be able to do that, being able to be the Enlilites, being able to go up and down, mentally extend and physically extend outwardly, upwardly and outwardly, upwardly and outwardly. That's going to be us as limitless thinkers, and, you know, limitless, you know, just limitless all over, you know, on all planes of existence, because, you know, these humans don't exist in the fourth dimension, or the eighth dimension, or the 12th dimension, or even outside this earth dimension. How are they going to do that if they can't even take the radiation? If they can't take the radiation here on this basic realm, they can't take the sun, they can't take the UV radiation, they can't even take nuclear radiation. If you gave it to them in full dosage, if you gave it to a so-called black person, they probably could take it. But if you give that same dosage to a so-called human, they're going to die, because their DNA is not of these, what you call Anunnaki, of these Nuteru, as these, you know, and with all these other old civilizations spoke about as these extended carbonated beings that walked this planet in the physical. You know, they talked about these. They got them written down on hieroglyphics. They got them written down in cuneiform, in, you know, the Sumerian text. You know, all these different you know, descriptions of previous limitless thinkers that are now up in extended cosmos, well over a thousands of years more intelligent than us. They're thousands of years more advanced than us, because they understood the purpose of community, and they understood that coming together ultimately extends you forward. It basically extends each and one of them forward. It extends the vibration. I'm telling you, I've had these most powerful connections in the last, what, week, previous 2 weeks with certain people of, you know, bronze race, you know, being able to, you know, connect with them on a, you know, emotional level, but, you know, basically through thought, you know, because think about when you begin asking questions, you know, that ultimately touch your emotions or touch your mind, that makes you think, you know, that's what you call mentally extending people's minds. You know, you us being those brightness, I mean, those bright rays, or being able to extend people's minds by way of our questioning, by way of our ideology, by way of who we are, our essence as these bright-minded people, as these limitless thinkers. Our thoughts are going to basically extend people around us. It's going to evolve these the remnants of these so-called black people, their minds out, and they're going to become what you call high thinkers. You know, they're going to become on the same level. You know, their minds are going to be able to ultimately eventually get to that point, but you know, some of them have to die off and then ultimately be born back into the fourth dimension, pretty much, because they can't get it right now. Because they can't get it right now. They've been barred out by way of what they do, by way of what they associate with themselves with. And, you know, it's just a limited. So some people are just not going to be able to get it. Because if you explain it like this to them, they're still not going to be able to get it. You know, they're not going to be able to get it because it's just over their head. The channeling is the channel is too extended. Because they say it's belief. They claim it's belief. They claim this is belief because it's not what they've heard of. They can't find it in any book. You know, you can't find this, you know, anywhere, you know, out in any, as far as this thought particular pattern. This thought pattern and this thought frequency, you can't pull it. You can't copy and paste it. No, because it's coming directly from me and it's coming from my extended self on a higher dimensional plane of living. It's coming from me. It's coming not from me, but through me, from our higher self and from a race of our higher selves. We're all receiving this, a race of them, me, my higher self, and a race of them through me, through transmission, through the frequencies, all of as above, so below. So I'm receiving it and I'm also pushing it out. I'm throwing it back out, being able to, you know, communicate. We're communicating through frequency and sound and vibration. So that's all that it really is in a nutshell. And they do that with the radio towers and these 5G towers. They do that. You know, people were dying from, people that say they died from COVID-19, they were dying from radio frequency, you know, cell poisoning. They're dying from cell poisoning. They were dying from cell poisoning. When you live next to those particular, you know, those towers, they put out a lot of energy. But for people like us that are, what you say, more deep, like, I would say, genetically advanced as far as this newer race or newer generation of so-called bronze, so-called black people known as now bronze people, we are more evolved. So would you say our immune systems have basically evolved? We've evolved as far as, like I said, our genetics markers have basically been extended because we've been taking so much radiation from the cosmos and radiation from just these artificial race of people's technology. Our bodies have basically evolved. We're diamonds, impenetrable diamonds. You know, we're impenetrable of what they're going to throw at us now and next. If they can't even make it to the next, so we're just saying now, you know, our bodies have extended forward to where anything they throw at us, they can't affect us. It can't affect us. No virus, no flu, no nothing. Anything that they throw at us, it doesn't affect us. You know, because if we're eating right and taking care of ourselves and we're, you know, exercising and stuff, and you know, we ultimately are taking care of our wealth. Health is wealth, so we're taking care of our wealth, the wealth of us living here longer and longer. You know the result of, you know, us taking care of ourselves is the wealth of, you know, living longer, being able to live longer and pull in transmission longer, being able to, you know, transmit it outwardly to, you know, be that bright, as the bright, you know, you're enlightening people around you. You're inspiring them every single day because of your different thought pattern, because it's different to them, because it inspires them. That's what it does. When you understand your, what you say, higher purpose, then it makes it easier living here. It just makes time here, because we are serving time. We're serving time. Like, say, if we were in prison or in school, we're serving time. But we've been able to move past that particular mindset, and you know, we're moving forward. We're extending ourselves. We're even happy. We're happy. But you say, in some sentimental way of saying happy, we've extended ourselves more and more each day by being able to remember why we've come here as a collective, or I guess remember why we're doing what we're doing. Because not a lot of people that I would see that I see now on you know, just on Facebook and everything else, you know, they're bright people, but you know, everybody has their own path but you know, eventually it's going to come down to us coming to a collective. So it's just a matter of time, you know. It's just a patient wait, and I'm not rushing. You know, there's no rush on this path. It's continuous. You don't want to get burnt out on a continuous path, just like running a marathon or doing cross country. You want to pace yourself. So we're pacing ourselves, and we relaxing, and we're just pulling in, and we're extending ourselves more and more each day. On all levels, on all planes of existence, we are extending ourselves. We are extending ourselves, and we do that. We do that, and we're proud of that. You know, people say, yo, you're being prideful. No, but yeah, we can do that because we're living again, and we're not existing anymore. When you stop existing and you begin living, it's like breathing. Actually learning how to, like, when you're actually breathing, we're living. We are extending because we are the limitless thinkers. When you can think outside of any box, which this, you know, the term black is a mental box. So when you think outside that mental box as a so-called black person, then you can see, you know, like the song goes, I can see clearly now, the rain is gone. Yes, we're seeing clearly because we elevated past that rain cloud and storm cloud. We're above that, and we see the sun directly. We see we're receiving the information from the sun directly, that direct current. Our skin is being, you know, hardened. Our minds have been, you know, etched, have broken out of the carbon state. Now we're in diamond state, that diamond mental state. We're seeing that. We see this every day. And it's just, it's, I can say this over and over again, because we accept our purpose. We accept our purpose. We're doing all that we can do. We're doing all that we can do to make an impression here in this third dimension, in a collective of UNONC, the United Nation of Next Nuclear. We are extending. We are mentally extending and physically extending by way of the mental. We're doing that. We claim that. We claim this every single day. And we're not proud of it. It makes you, what you say, gully. I mean, not gully, but just, you know, it gives you that feeling of just knowing. I mean, that particular feeling of that there's a brighter day coming. You know, there's no more optimism. No, we know there's a brighter day. You know, there is no second guessing anything at this point. We're one. It's direct current. It's 1-1-1-1-1. It's not 1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2. No, we're 1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1. That's the frequency, and that's how fast it's coming out. Maybe a little bit faster than that. It has to be faster than that. Fast enough to where it's altering our lives every day. Ultimately fast enough to where we're feeling these retrogrades on some whole different, I would say not pain levels, but we're feeling it on all different levels as these super sensitized empaths and super sensitized channelers. Again, super sensitized empaths and super sensitized channelers. We're basically channeling energy on the, what you say, emotional or but 3D plane as far as the atmosphere, and then we're channeling on higher atmosphere realms or ranges. We're channeling in on higher atmosphere or higher dimensional ranges, just like a radio would. It has many channels that it could pull in, or many different radio stations it could, you know, hone in and, you know, pull in pretty much. So we're just like that. We are just like that. So, you know, we ultimately see our, we know what our purpose is, and we're practicing what we do. It's called being able to practice what you preach is ultimately what it boils down to. You know, are we actually doing what we're saying we're doing? Yes, we are. On a continuous basis. On a continuous basis. We're doing this because we're extending ourselves. We are extending ourselves every day. And we get extended ourselves. We get extended by way of our thinking and our thought processes being, being extended by way of this new energy and this new bright codes that are being put down here. We're pulling all of that in. We're pulling all of that in, you know, more and more each day. So here we have it. I want to go on a quick music break. Peace and pop.
But in the game I lost you, what a price to pay. I'm crying. Ooh, baby, baby. Ooh, baby, baby. Out. Baby, I
I can do to you, and so many ways I can please. Hey, 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 it's your move, yeah. Why don't you start turning down the lights and show me just what you can do? Hey, baby, I've had my share of lovers, some of them were damn good.
Because I wear my hair red, or because I like to play the piano.